Kaohsiung Mayor Han Kuo-yu is in the final days of his China trip and is facing a political maelstrom back home. Here in Taiwan, a storm is brewing over the mayor's sit-down meetings with the top Chinese officials, including the head of Beijing's Office for Taiwan Affairs. Taiwan's Mainland Affairs Council has demanded that the mayor complete a full debriefing upon his return. DPP lawmakers accuse Han of selling out Taiwan, saying he's exchanging the nation's sovereignty for short-term benefits.
He declared his fervent support for the 1992 consensus as a cornerstone for cross-strait relations. The Kaohsiung mayor's so-called trade trip ultimately took him behind closed doors with the director of the Taiwan Affairs Office. It's a turn of events that's raised eyebrows even in Hong Kong, where some critics accused him of selling out Taiwan.
Our founding father Sun Yat-sen overthrew the Manchurian Qing Dynasty and founded the Republic of China in the pursuit of democracy, the power of the people, and people's livelihood. It was all for bettering the lives of the people.
DPP lawmakers say Han is hiding political maneuvering behind the curtain of trade. They called him out for failing to defend Taiwan's sovereignty.
Han Kuo-yu doesn't dare broach the issue of the ROC sovereignty. When he talks about the ROC, he just talks about its history, and he even gets it wrong. It's nationalism, democracy, and people's livelihood. He said it was democracy, the power of the people, and people's livelihood.
Han fired back on his critics, saying that the DPP was having a case of sour grapes.
They are like Pigsy, who couldn't sell the ginseng fruits. I'm like the Monkey King, who's starting to sell them. Why are you being such a drag? You can't get the orders yourself. You can't find your own way. And still, you just smear my name behind my back with bitter comments. That's extremely lame. Taiwan's people hope that boosting trade will not come at the cost of future generations' democratic freedom. We do not want to trade that for a fictitious, illusory, and fleeting economic gain.
On this so-called politics-free trip, Han has visited official Chinese agencies one after the other. His visits have drawn the attention of the Mainland Affairs Office, which says it will ask Han to explain himself upon returning to Taiwan. If he's found to have violated laws on cross-strait cooperation, he could be fined 500,000 NT.